rice is the main staple crop of India. Rice is a kharif crop. It requires temperature above 25 degrees Celsius with high humidity. The annual rainfall required is more than 100 cm and it grows well on alluvial soil. The area of production of rice are plains of north and northeastern India, coastal areas and deltaic regions, the states of West Bengal, Andhra Pradesh, Punjab, Tamil Nadu and Kerala. Wheat is the second staple crop of India. It is a rabi crop. It requires 50 to 75 cm of annual rainfall and cool growing season and bright sunshine at the time of ripening. It grows well on alluvial loamy soil. It grows in the state of Punjab, Haryana, UP, Bihar and Rajasthan mainly. The areas of production of wheat are Ganga Satluj Plains in the northwestern, black soil region of Deccan. Jowar is a millet crop. It is a rain-fed crop grown in moist areas. Maharashtra is the largest producer, followed by Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh and Madhya Pradesh. Bajra is another millet. It grows well on sandy soil and shallow black soil. Rajasthan is the largest producer of bajra, followed by Uttar Pradesh, Maharashtra, Gujarat and Haryana. Ragi is also a millet crop. It grows in dry region, grows well on red, black, sandy, loamy and shallow black soil. Karnataka is the largest producer of ragi, followed by Tamil Nadu, Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Sikkim, Jharkhand and Arunachal Pradesh. Maize is a kharif crop. It requires 21 to 27 degrees Celsius while growing. It grows well on old alluvial soil. In Bihar, it is grown as rabi season crop. It also grows in UP, MP, Karnataka and Andhra Pradesh. India is the largest producer as well as the consumer of pulses in the world. Major pulses that are grown in India are tur, that is arhar, urad, moong, masoor, peas and gram. Major pulse producing states in India are Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, Maharashtra, Uttar Pradesh and Karnataka. Sugarcane takes almost 1 year to grow. It requires temperature between 21 to 27 degrees Celsius and rainfall between 75 to 100 cm. It grows well on a variety of soils. India is the second largest producer of sugarcane in the world. In India, it is mainly grown in UP, Maharashtra, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Punjab, Haryana, and Bihar. Main oil seeds produced in India are groundnut, mustard, coconut, sesamum, that is til, soybean, castor seeds, cotton seeds, lean seed, and sunflower. Groundnut is a kharif crop and accounts for about half of the major oil seeds produced in the country. Gujarat was the largest producer of groundnut, followed by Rajasthan and Tamil Nadu in 2015-16. Lean seed and mustard are rabi crops. Sesamum is a kharif crop in north and rabi crop in south India. Castor seed is grown both as rabi and kharif crop. Tea is a beverage crop and India is the leading producer as well as exporter of tea in the world. It grows well on well-drained soil, rich in humus and organic matter. Tea requires warm, moist, frost-free days and frequent showers evenly distributed over the years. Tea grows well in Assam, hills of Darjeeling and Jalpaiguri in West Bengal, Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Himachal, Uttarakhand, Meghalaya, Andhra Pradesh and Tripura. Coffee is also a beverage crop. It requires cool climate. It grows well in hilly region on well-drained soil. Coffee is grown in Karnataka, Kerala and Tamil Nadu. Horticulture includes production of fruits and vegetables. India is a producer of tropical as well as temperate fruits and vegetables. Major horticulture crops produced in India are pea, cauliflower, onion, cabbage, tomato, brinjal, and potato. Mangoes are majorly grown in Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Uttar Pradesh, and West Bengal. Oranges are famous of Nagpur and Cherrapunji, Meghalaya. Bananas are famous of Kerala, Mizoram, Maharashtra and Tamil Nadu. Uttar Pradesh and Bihar is famous for lychee and guava. Pineapples grows well in Meghalaya. Grapes of Andhra Pradesh, Telangana and Maharashtra. Apples, pears, apricots and walnuts grows well in Jammu and Kashmir and Himachal Pradesh. Rubber is an equatorial crop. It requires temperature above 25 degrees Celsius and moist and humid climate. Rainfall more than 200 centimeter. Rubber is grown in India in Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Meghalaya, Andaman and Nicobar. Thank you. Cotton is a fiber crop. It grows in kharif season. It requires an average temperature of 25 degrees Celsius and rainfall about 100 cm. It requires 210 frost-free days, and cotton grows well on black soil. Cotton is grown in India in Maharashtra, Gujarat, MP, Punjab and Haryana. Jute is another fiber crop. It is also grown in kharif season in India. It requires temperature on an average 25 to 30 degrees Celsius and rainfall between 150 to 200 centimeter. It grows well in well-drained fertile soil. In India, jute is grown in Bengal, Bihar, Assam, Odisha and Meghalaya. Now note down this table and learn for examination. The Government of India has introduced various institutional and technological reforms to improve agriculture in 1980s and 1990s. Support this statement with examples. The following are the institutional reforms done in India in agriculture. Number 1 is collectivization and consolidation of land holdings were done to make them economically viable. The Green Revolution based on the use of package technology and the White Revolution to increase milk production has been implemented. Cooperation with farmers and abolition of Jamindari system has took place. Provision of crop insurance to protect the farmers against losses caused by natural calamities, that is drought, flood, cyclone, fire and disease has been made. Establishment of Grameen banks, cooperative societies and banks, Kisan Credit Card, Personal Accident Insurance Scheme has been set up. Special weather bulletins and agricultural programs for farmers on radio and TV is forecasted to help them. Announcement of minimum support price, remunerative and procurement prices for crops to check the exploitation of farmers is done. The declining share of agriculture in the gross domestic product, GDP, is a matter of serious concern in India. Support the statement. The following points are about the contribution of agriculture to the national economy, employment and output. In 2010-11, about 52% of the total workforce was employed by the farm sector, but the share of agriculture in the GDP is declining, which is a serious concern as it will lead to a decline in other spheres of economy too. Indian farmers are facing a big challenge from international competition and reduction in the public investment in agricultural sector. Despite being an important producer of rice, cotton, rubber, tea, coffee, jute and spices, our agricultural products are not able to compete with the developed countries because of the highly subsidized agriculture in those countries. Though the GDP growth rate of agriculture is declining over the years, it is not generating sufficient employment opportunities in the country. Explain the impact of globalization on Indian agriculture and suggest some measures to improve its conditions. Following are the impact of globalization on agriculture. Under globalization, particularly after 1990, the farmer in India have been exposed to new challenges of land degradation along with changing market conditions. Despite being an important producer of rice, cotton, rubber, tea, coffee, jute and spices, our agricultural products are not able to compete with the developed countries because of the highly subsidized agriculture in those countries. To make agriculture successful and profitable, proper thrust should be given to the improvement of the condition of marginal and small farmers. There is a prevailing demand for organic farming because it is practiced without factory-made chemicals such as fertilizers and pesticides. Indian farmers should diversify their cropping pattern from cereals to high-value crops. This will increase incomes and reduce environmental degradation simultaneously. Now practice some previous years asked questions. Thank you for watching. Please do subscribe the channel.